Remember that I entered the presidency midstream. So I have to just make a go of what's available, but uunahin ko kayo. Now, in our talks during the command conference, I was informed there is a need for more soldiers. And though I have a source somewhere, it's about 20, wala akong pera. Mga 10 siguro for additional soldiers on the ground. Because I would need about 3,000 policemen to meet the challenges of urban terrorism. We are in a transition. The world itself is in a transition. Everybody has a problem somewhere, except for a few countries in South America. Lahat tayo may problema, and it's always, it has deteriorated into a terrorism thing. And ang problema dyan, because it cuts borders, walang specific objective is to establish a country. If you want to rebel, hindi ganun eh. Or you want to put down a dictator because it's a despot. Wala rin yan. It's just simply that they are there fighting, and kagaya ng Middle East, the reason is just to kill. Ang buti dito, because there's a reason. And they are into it for kidnapping, money. At least kung ganun lang. And we're better off than the others. But on a long term, you know, we have a problem. As a nation, it has started many, many years ago. Para tayong sinasampal. So every time there's a foreigner executed, or a local, and with a dimension such as yung nakikita, kasi pinipikula, may pinikula, it, yung mapapahit, embarrasses the country, that all the soldiers and the policemen, we cannot stop this kind of terrorism. One day we'll just have to decide. And one day we'll just have to say, we'll finish everything. Hindi pwede yung araw-araw sampalin tayo ng ganito. And look, sabi nila ako noon, berdogo ako ng Davao. I was the only one executing the criminals. Eh, kalba, ngayon, lumabas na. See? Makita mo, ang nag-surrender is 80,000 plus. Where can you find a country that even doon sa prisuhan, anak ng, nagluluto ng shabu? They were arrested outside for committing the crime precisely of manufacturing shabu. And yet, pagdating doon, nagluluto pa. Parang nakaka-insulto ang, but I said, this has to stop. Now, I cannot tell you the whereabouts of the drug problem, but maybe privately I can tell you. Magtanong na lang kayo sa mga official ninyo. We have a serious problem. The enemy is it's not within our reach. So, no, ang laro nito, well, I don't know, but you'll have just to support the government, not to me personally. I do not want anybody cultivating a loyalty sa akin personally. Ayaw ko yan. I started from the ranks, started a special counsel. Yun ang pinakamababa ng sa prosecution. Started on where? Fourth? Third? Second, I was taken in as Vice Mayor of Davao. EDSA Revolution. Then I became Mayor in 1988. Progressive yan. Sa awa ng Diyos, I won all the elections in my life. Maybe I take pride in winning the presidency, but I'm fighting a war here. Drugs doon, Manila and other places, and dito sa ibang Mindanao, it's terrorism. It will need your sacrifice. And mine too. But alam ninyo, you'll have to come in very fast. We are stretched thin. Wala akong pulis na ilatag ko dyan in every corner. Tapos, ang Cebu, it's rampaging. I said, it's beyond our reach yung problema dyan. Do not look for them. Magsabi sila na, oh, where's the big fish? Bakit maliliit lang? Wala, private lang ito lahat. Ang general sa ito. It's just orchestrated. Pati itong meeting na ito, alam ko, monitor. And for all you know, may picture pa sila. Ganon ang hirap ng gera na to. So, you have to love your country. Do it for the love of country. Do not do it for me. I do not need it. Trabaho tayong lahat. Sabi ko, ako, trabahante lang ako. Kayong mga ano ko, I have my simple ones. Hindi ko nga alam bakit ako na dumating dito sa presidency. But I told the story sa doon sa command conference. How I came about to be here with you tonight. Ito lang ang masabi ko. Do your duty. If you are ordered for an operation against Cebu, nagkasabit-sabit kayo. Huwag kayo. I will be there in the fulfillment of duty or in the performance of your task, mandate. You will have my support 100%. I will not allow you to go to jail. Ako ang mauna. Akin yan lang. Kung lahat ng in-execute ninyo, utos ko, akin yan. Mine and mine alone. Ako yan. Basta yung trabaho natin. So, huwag kayong matakot. And you might be charged. I take solace from my statement. I am there for you. So, hindi na lang ako magtagal. I have to go to the wounded soldiers. Mag-ikot ako. I will look for money. At kayo, pagka nakaproblema, alam mo na yung the imponderables of life, yung hindi mo nakita. Sawa, kapatid, may cancer, gano'n. Huwag na kayong pumunta ng malayo. Just go to your commanding officer. And he will call me. And I will look for ways to help you. Huwag na kayong pumasok dyan sa kung ano-ano pa ang makautang. Pagka medyo mabigat, alam, marami yan, ha? Patay, tuition, o whatever. Dami nga niyang cancer, maghirap ko. Palamin mo lang ako. Kaya sana nga noon, ipagbili ko yung Pag-asa to rebuild yung Biluna. Pero sabi nila, nobody's no takers yan kasi luma na, mahina. So, I will either convert it into a hospital. Tingnan ko lang kung how much I would spend. Gawain ko yung hospital ninyo. Ilagay ko sa, well, wherever the fighting is. Sirain ko lang yung loob. Bigyan ko ng, lagyan ko ng mga operating ano rooms. Parang yan ang gawin ko. Walang silbi yung barko na yan eh. So, kinabangan na lang natin. If somebody is willing to sell it, pag ang kita niyan, maasahan ninyo, diretso, I will rebuild the Biluna. I'll complete it. I will add another building, maybe a new one, and you will have the comparative best medical treatment. It will have everything. CT scan, at ano yung mga imaging. I'll spend money. So, and we will improve the hospitals. Kung anong immediate and urgent needs to be there. Huwag kayong maano, basta inutosan kayo to do a civilian mandate, for example, drugs. Go ahead. Hindi na ako magtanong kung paano mo ginawa. Basta ako, pag nakasabit kayo sa trabaho, mandated by law, batas, hindi naman natin yan, you will have my protection. And I said, isa lang tayo. Do not be too extra courteous to me or respectful. Kasi naiilang ako. Anak lang rin ako ng migrant dito sa Mindanao. Nung umalis kami ng Cebu, Well, of course, my mother is my... Pero ang tatay ko, mahirap lang kami. So I know how it is to be poor and to work for your life, for the government. E dumating ako sa edad na ito, I think it's destiny naging presidente ako. They want to assure everybody in this republic, layo ng tayong taga-gobyerno, that you have a president who'd share with you yung mga problema and of course the little blessings that we get from God and from the people of the Republic of the Philippines. Salamat po.
Discover new cultures. Live life's sweet discoveries. It's a bit spicy.